Welcome to part 2 of the Kids Can Do Secchi Disc video series. This video will demonstrate how to build the Secchi Disc and show how easy it is for students to use their homemade device to collect water clarity data. As we discussed in part 1 of this video series, a Secchi Disc is a simple device that you can easily make from low-cost items purchased at your local hardware store or from parts scavenged around the house or classroom. Building and using a Secchi Disc to monitor the water clarity in a lake near you can make a great science project. You will need the following items to make your Secchi Disc. However, you don't need to copy all this information down right now. A link to full instructions with a supply list and tips and tricks for assembly is provided at the end of this video. What you will see us using to build the Secchi Disc in this video includes some white paracord, playground sand, two metal washers about 1¼ inches in diameter, a white 5-gallon bucket lid, an empty 20-ounce beverage bottle, and a black Sharpie Magnum.
Now let's build a Secchi Disc together. Number 1, if your plastic is not 20 centimeters to begin with, trace out a 20 centimeter circle. Number 2, punch a hole in the disc and trim off any extra plastic. Number 3, draw an X on the circle and use the black waterproof marker to color opposite quarters of the X to get the proper Secchi pattern. Number 4, fill your bottle with sand. The bottle will be used as a weight to stabilize the disc and help it to sink. It doesn't need to be filled all the way to the top, but you should try to get it better than half full of sand. Once you have a good amount of sand in your bottle, fill it to the top with water and seal it tightly. Number 5. Mark a gauge on your rope. Secchi discs made by research supply companies usually come with about 6 meters of rope on the disc. To help you read the depth more quickly, we suggest you mark every 10 centimeters from the disc to the end of the rope in black, and if you have other colored markers, it can be helpful to mark every 100 centimeters from the disc in a different color. Number 6. Assemble our pieces and parts. First, put a tight knot into the rope about 12 to 18 inches from the short end of the rope, and then slide the washer onto the rope. This is important. Keep track of which end is your short end and long end. You want to assemble your disc working from the short end. Next, slide the Secchi disc onto the rope so that the patterned side faces the washer and the long end of the rope. Again, be sure that you have the patterned side of the disc facing the long end. This is the up orientation. When you use the disc, you want the pattern facing up so you can see it in the water. Then slide on the second washer. Carefully tie a tight knot which sandwiches the first washer, Secchi disc, and second washer tightly between the first and second knots. The purpose of this is to provide some stability to the disc and to ensure it doesn't slide around on the rope while you are using it. If you are unsure how tight your knots are, you can use some glue to keep them tied tightly and in place. Number 7. Lastly, tie your sand bottle to the bottom of the short end of the rope. Be sure to secure the bottle well. Use some glue if you are unsure your knots will remain tight. Number 8. Now you are ready to take some water clarity measurements.
Thanks for joining us for this Kids Can Do Make Your Own Secchi Disc video series. We hope you will build your very own device and use it to monitor water clarity in a lake or pond near you. For more information, a supply list, detailed instructions, and tips and tricks for assembly, please visit our website. See you next time.